Hi, I'm Romina Percy and welcome back to Earth from Space. Today, the Copernicus Sentinel-2 mission takes us over the fragments of swirling sea ice off the coast of Greenland. In this image captured on the 9th of June 2019, small pieces of sea ice, known as ice floes, trace out the ocean currents beneath. This results in a large swirl-like feature, approximately 120 kilometers in diameter. The ice is located in the Irminger Sea, just south of the Denmark Strait between Greenland and Iceland. This ice, which was formed by the freezing of the sea surface in the Arctic Ocean, has drifted southwards along the coast of Greenland before arriving at this location. The ice swirl is considered a typical eddy or vortex, commonly found in the summer marginal ice zone off the east coast of Greenland. The marginal ice zone is the transition region from the open ocean, visible in dark blue, to the white sea ice. Depending on wind direction, waves, and ocean currents, it can consist of small, isolated ice floes drifting over a large area to smaller ice floes pressed together in bright white bands. Strong mesoscale air-ice-ocean interactive processes drive the advance and retreat of the sea ice edge and result in the meanders or eddies visible in this region. Investigations of such ocean eddies and meanders began in the 1970s and 1980s in the Greenland Sea to gain a better understanding of the interactions between the ocean, ice, and atmosphere. Copernicus Sentinel-2 is a two-satellite mission. Each satellite carries a high-resolution camera that images Earth's surface in 13 spectral bands. Together, they cover all of Earth's land surfaces, large islands, inland and coastal waters every 5 days at the equator. And this brings us to the end of this edition. I'm Romina Percy from ESA Web TV Studios, and thank you for watching.